considering how, like today, reading the newspaper, how all over the world there's so many horrible wars going on in different countries, Liberia, civil wars that have rifted by countries. Seems since it's the exception. A lot of people getting killed in different places. A one world government is a solution to that. England was all over the world. It was a vast empire at one time. And you could say that for a long period of time there was peace within the empire that they were ruling. I was reading about Benjamin Franklin, some place he stayed here in London, and he gave a history about how they're all Englishmen, all the American founding fathers were English. And they, their claim was, we don't want to pay taxation unless we have representation. England was already a democracy then. They were English, and because they were in the colonies, they weren't taxed. So there was a good tax, they were going to stay in the colonies. But then England wanted to tax the colonies. And then, so they said, you want to tax us and give us representation. Give us a vote in the House of Commons too. But they, for some reason, England didn't get it. They didn't want. And I was just thinking how the whole history of the world would have been changed. And whoever were the members of Parliament at that time had given American colonies the vote, the representation, some kind of representation. Hey, England would probably still be if England had given a vote to India, there wouldn't be India, or there would be America. It would be like still the vast empire, English empire. Of course, England itself would be a minority in terms of its representation in front of us, but they were anyway, that's not how history happened. But at some point in time, having a world government would be very useful to stop all these little wars that are going on. Because at that time, you had one king, one emperor, and all the kings under him, he had more military power. He could impose peace. If some they started fighting against each other, in those days, of course, the Kshatriyas would fight against the Kshatriyas. It wouldn't involve their common people. So any kind of little disputes, they just had duels, like the old wars, you know, the duels, and things. It didn't involve anybody else. So the world was a much more peaceful place. Now we have all these little countries, but the United Nations is very weak. So anyone that's a little powerful, they can do what they want, and later, try to work it out or something. Bring the world very easily into war situations. Anyway, it's not a topic, but this is something that the Prabhupada was discussing, that in the future, having a world government would actually be useful if it was God conscious. Was it reasonable? So in that relevance, we can have relation, we can see that here, but there was a one world government at that time. The world was a peaceful place. As long as the rulers are good, then the world is peaceful. The government has to be fair and equitable. So that kind of a setup, maybe under the United Nations, something is needed. The present thing is not working. You get some time entrenched in some country. I think Saddam was in Iraq, and they torture all the people and kill people, and then there's no hope for anybody. So in the Vedic time, there were certain rules. The ruler, if he wasn't following the rules, he could be removed. He had to, every ruler had to follow the Vedic rules. They had to be charitable, they had to be just, they had to be good. They weren't just like the brahmanas who moved the Pitu's father, Venu, because he was a rascal. Right now, if you get some tyrant somewhere, what's the process? Remove. So people do revolution. And the revolution means, you know, very bloody guerrilla warfare, terrorism. So you see what we have today in the world, and you see the relative of what the situation was before, you can see, well, it was quite a peaceful place. Now this anyway, there's a system, I forget what the official name of that is called, the technical word in English, where the monarchy passes on to the eldest son. There's no eldest son, and how it passes on is codes. So it seems that code which was used millions of years ago in the time of Pitu Maharaj, it's still followed even here, like in England. There's no son, and it becomes a queen, the rise. There's a son, and it becomes a son. So we have Prince Charles and William following that same system. But then, in those days, they would divide up. There would be emperor, and then they would give different parts of the world to other of the family members to rule over. And that way things would be managed. But they were all subordinate to the emperor. Chaitanya, in the Bhakti Ratnakar, it describes how all the books of Chaitanya pastimes were stolen by this king Vishnupura. His name was Mahadev Mahasha. And in the details, Srinivasacharya is looking everywhere for the books and wants to go see the king. So he went to see the king to find his books. And then the books, the Acharya's books, the whole Sampradaya's books, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, all of those Swami's texts. And then, but this king, Biram Vikram Maharaj, his kingdom was a very poor kingdom, mostly forests, and not so much agriculture, but of course, in all of it, there was no industry anyway. So he didn't have so much income. He was a poor king relative to other kings. They had more agricultural land or mineral wealth or something. So he augmented his purse by sending out the thieves. He had secret police that were actually put to steal from the path travelers passing through his kingdom. And when they come to him, they get police complaint that there's a thief, and they were very sympathetic, and so we'll look into it. Give us your address, and find anything, we'll tell you all about it. And that was the end of it. Because actually, the thieves were state M19, M16, whatever, secret police, and they were given, put on this task. So, in this way, some astrologer had told him that some priceless treasure was being taken on the road to his kingdom. There's no protection, a few guards and a few mallards. He said, well, it's like nothing, you know. A priceless, this treasure, he said, the astrologer said, it's worth more than, he said it's here, it's so priceless, it's worth more than diamonds, and rubies, and jewels. It's like, so the king said, well, wow, this must be like crown jewel, like diamond, the biggest, you know, rugby balls or something. You know? And was, you know, I really couldn't figure out what this could be. So priceless. And so he called his most trusted secret service guys, police, and he made a deal. You don't open up the box, you just bring it right to me, and I give each of you 1,000 gold coins. It was huge, you know, I don't think that much. And the whole thing worked out. Brought the treasure there, he put it in his treasure house, gave all of them the remuneration for their undercover job. So when they had gone there, Srinivasacharya and Shyamananda Pandit and Narottam Das Thakur were with the books. But they were sleeping that night. And there was a couple of guards that was given by the Barakpur Maharaj, king of Barakpur. I mean, they were also asleep. So it was nothing. They just came, took the box away. There was no fight, no anything. It was really easy job for them. They came and gave us, as I take candy from a baby. But when the acharyas woke up early in the morning to do their job, and they saw the books are gone, they're freaking out. They looked everywhere, asked the guards what happened. We were sleeping, you know, they're hitting their heads against the trees, they're rolling in the ground. What are the acharyas going to think? What's all these great devotees who think these are priceless? They're the original copies. There was no copy, the originals. Handwritten text, there's no like a computer printouts or something. And these were going to be taken, they were being taken to be copied. So that the way you preserve the books, and there are many people hand copy them, and that way they were distributed. He said, no, where are the books? And they're just going mad. And then Srinivasacharya, he told them, look, you go to your places, and I was the one entrusted by Radha Govinda Giri. Let me search it out. So then he went and searched out, couldn't find, went to see the king. And he was, every day the king would have a Bhagavatam class in the afternoon. So Srinivas sat down in the assembly, and then he was hearing his Bhagavatam class. It was a total speculation. The person was Karma Kanda, Gyana Kanda, but there was zero bhakti, and it was so horrible. His explanation that Srinivas was feeling sick during the whole class. He looked at me, looked at two. Oh. So the king said, what's wrong with you? You don't like my guru's class? Making all these funny faces. He said, well, this class, the Bhagavatam was great, but his explanation, I was really, didn't make me feel good. Oh, really? Okay, we want you to give up a class. And if we don't feel good, then you're going to be decapitated for your offense to our guru. You better give a good class. Can you imagine the kind of pressure of giving a class? Would you like to give a life and death class? Well, Srinivasacharya was given the title of Acharya in Vrindavan because he was really an Acharya. He was a very expert Bhagavatam class giver. So he gave a wonderful class. And as a result, then the king, he thought that, well, the king, when he got his books, he put them in his treasury, he opened up the box. He was afraid that if my police see it, then they may even, you know, kill me to take all these jewels. So, you know, anybody to see, he opens up the box. Books! Books! What are these books? That's really priceless jewels. He looks and all he sees,
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Daita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda
Jaya
Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Daita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Pande rupa sanata navareno si jivano vato. Sasada bhakti vasamita siddhu. These are some kind of religious books. I've stolen literary jewels, literary priceless treasures from some who called back the police. What is this books here? Who did you take it from? Oh, there were actually two Vaishnavas, a few like their gurus. Oh no, I was stolen the books from the saint. I'm going to hell for sure now. I was stealing from all these rich businessmen, you know, giving to the people of my poor country, but now I've stolen from some saint, some Brahmin of Vaishnavas. I know he's finished. Find them. You gotta give them back the books. But don't let anybody know. Yeah, but didn't know that I stole the books. So it was a whole, you know, really critical thing, how to get the books back to the original owners, and nobody knows that the books were stolen by the people. So when he heard the Srinivas Acharya, this amazing class, I never heard such a class before. It was about Krishna, Bhagavatam about Krishna, about bhakti, devotional service, all these things they never heard about before. In the Bhagavatam, the teacher would focus on totally other things. So then he thought maybe he's the person. So then the answer is very grateful. Well, I would like to talk with you in private. So nobody knew what's going to happen. No. It seemed to be a good plan. So then the king took him behind in private and he said, "Who are you?" Then he gives this explanation how the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Sri Krishna, descended into this world as Satisutta, as Lord Chaitanya, in Navadvipa, and how he disseminated the mercy and love of Krishna all over India, and how the Rupa and Sanatana, who were Davir Kash and Sakir Malik, the Prime Minister and the Finance Minister of the Emperor Hussein Shah, how they had, and many other great saintly people, gone to Vrindavan, and had got the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, were writing the ancient texts. So like somewhere in there, then they came up, I thought those people were crazy. They were the most powerful people in the entire empire, other than the emperor. I mean, they ran the whole thing. The emperor didn't do anything. He was out hunting. Rupa Sanatana, Sanatana Goswami was the prime minister without voting. I mean, they didn't have him after 3 years in Africa. He was so good that the emperor was totally happy. In fact, when he wanted to leave, he arrested him. That's how popular. You can't leave. You have to stay as my prime minister. I want to leave. You ever seen that in English? I want to leave. No, you must stay. That's the very once. Oh, there was one king abdicated. He was married a couple. So this king, he was saying, I used to have to go and I had to bow down to them. I had to pay my taxes to the Rupa Goswami. He was, you know, he was the finance minister. So in that, that's why I got to this, because you get a little glimpse like how it worked, you know. Every king, he would collect taxes from all his subjects. One third of whatever taxes he collected, he had to give to the emperor. Two-thirds he could use to run his kingdom. There was a system. maybe two-thirds of Mother Family. It was like a system. So then the lords, under each king, there were lords and earls, and they also collected taxes, and they had to give to the king, whatever the king got, he gave the emperor. And every year, the kings had to give so many soldiers to the emperor. And the emperor was responsible to protect all the kings. He had a bigger army. So in case someone other from outside was attacking the empire, and there was too big an army for the local kings to defend against, then the empire's main army would come there and protect. It was a system. So then Srinivasacharya, he was explaining all these things in the king was mind. Then he has explained how all these books were written by all these great souls, and that he was entrusted by the Radha Govinda Devi to give the whole history. He was carrying these books to be copied in Navadvipa, and these books were stolen from him. The king, you know, his hairs were standing, uh-oh, he's the one. He's the owner, when he fell at Srinivasacharya's feet and grabbed his feet. I took the books, I took them, please forgive me. Please forgive me, take me as your disciple. And forgive me for all my offenses, because the guru always forgetting the offenses of the disciple. So he knew that he had to become the disciple of Srinivasa, and he could get forgiven. Blessing him so much faith that he was really a great acharya to bring his class. But Srinivasa, he wasn't even impressed that right now some king wants to be my disciple. He was, let me show you the books. I've been all there, he's building out the books, show me the books, let me see. So he took to the treasure house, and there saw this, the box. He said how excited he was. And then the box was opened. He saw that somehow Chaitanya Charitamrita had come to the top. When they packed it, they put it in the bottom. When they opened it, it had come to the top. So that's always used. The Chaitanya Charitamrita is like the cream of the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's literatures. So you cannot, I mean, we cannot begin to imagine how relieved Srinivasacharya was when he saw those books. Because by that time, the news had already reached Vrindavan, and all the acharyas in Vrindavan, they heard the books were stolen. They were not eating, they weren't sleeping, they were like completely delirious. Because those books were the lifeline, they were the life and soul of all the devotees. And when they were stolen, it was just like devastating for them. Like imagine no Chaitanya Charitamrita, no nectar of devotion. Or just be that, oh, we have Bhagavan Amritas. So the devotees, they were, when they saw those books, it was like, they gave life to everybody. And those quickly got, somehow, but the books were recovered. So the king said, look at, you don't need to go to Navadvipa to copy the books. I will bring pundits here and they can copy here. I'll finance the whole thing. It's my service. But actually, this king, he got liberated. He got finally, actually, so big thing though, to be a king's guru, he had to be a grihastha. And Srinivasacharya was not, I can't see what time it is, the button is in front of the watch. Oh, that gives me an excuse to go. Supposed to end at quarter two? So he didn't know what to do. So he discussed with, at that time, all the senior devotees were already gone from the world, but there was Narahari Thakur. He asked him whether he should, he was his Siksha Guru, senior Vaishnava. So he said, should I become the king's guru or not? If I become king's guru, I have to be married, because king's guru has to advise the king Like what we tell people, like we said in sannyasi, if there's something sometimes, well, talk to a senior grihastha, it's not grihastha. But the king can't go off and ask somebody else, he can only ask his guru. He only tells his intimate personal problems to his guru. So the guru has to be able to hear all the problems. Even if they're A, whatever, XX, whatever problem he has. He has to be able to hear that and give him counsel. So, therefore you have to be a grihastha, so that you can. So Narahari said, Narahari said, it's okay, you do it, you can do it. So that's why Srinivasacharya got married. But he spent only about 4 months at his house, and 8 months he spent at to his palace. It was just, so that's another interesting thing happened in the history afterwards. Because you see, like when just before the British came, the kingdoms in India started to get weaker. The empires were starting to crumble. The Mughals were losing their control. And at that time, there was a guy called Bhaskar Pandit. And he was a Maharashtrian thief, like a dacoit. He wasn't a royal family or anything. But he had gradually amassed an army of 10,000 people. So he would go and conquer kingdoms, but he just looted and steal from the people. And he wasn't interested in somebody like governing, and he wasn't, it was uncivilized guy. But he would conquer over, and then he'd take over some kingdoms. So it was, the empire wasn't able to defend against him. The empire was finished, end of its thing. So the kings were on their own, more or less. So they went, so this Bhaskar Pandit, he said they went to near Katwa, and he just looted all the Brahmin villages. He hated Brahmin culture. Envious of Brahmanas, looked even at that. Hated Vaishnavas. So it said that, so you kind of see how empires used to work and how you need a strong emperor to keep. It was a really interesting pastime that this was a 13th generation, it was like, I don't know how many generations, it was something like 13 generations, just before the British came. So already they had cannons. Cannons were already a part of the weaponry at that time, it was 200-300 years ago. And the amazing thing happened was many times this Bhaskar Pandit was attacking the kingdom of Vishnupur. And by that time there were 13 Radha Krishna temples, because after the initiation of the Maharaj by Srinivasacharya, every subsequent king also got initiated as a Gaudiya Vaishnava. Each one built their own Radha Krishna temple. And there's beautiful terracotta, artistic Radha Krishna temples there. But now all the temples, because the kings also during the British rule, after that, somehow all the temples now, whatever, I don't know the history exactly how they became, but the kings don't have any more kingdom, they don't have any more money, but they're the official owners of these temples. So all the deities are packed up in one temple because they can't do the worship in 13. But there's the most amazing deity of Srinivasacharya of Gaura-Nithai I've ever seen. I mean, these deities, Gaura-Nithai, they're really huge and they're very healthy. I mean, very strong, like not sometimes even effeminate kind of, these are very strong Gaura-Nithai. Beautiful, beautiful lotus eyes. And I was just amazed. When I was in temple, and dark, there's no light. It's the government that calls them all monuments, so they don't, nobody can touch them because they're protected monuments, historical monuments, but they don't give any money. Outside on the monument, they got these huge halogen lights. Inside, they got a little 25-watt bulb. So the devious is no light, and one in a minute, he put some light there. Wow. So beautiful devious at work. Then, beautiful Radha Krishna Devis, and there's one named Radha Krishna Devi, I think Radha Madan Mohan, who was firstly worshipped by Srinivas Acharya. And this land, this, the king at this time, when Bhaskar Pandit, he was attacking, he said he was approaching, and so the king said, let the whole kingdom for one day not fight, but everybody chant for 24 hours Hare Krishna. We'll just do Hare Krishna chanting, get the empowerment, and we'll go and fight. But that was a weird, because this Bhaskar Pandit, he wasn't a chatti, he didn't follow, his like a yavan or something. He did, when he saw all these people are not going to fight me, okay, we'll attack them right now in the night. Well, just to go and attack them, because the king said, no one should lift an arm. So he got his whole, he moved it up, and the next day was supposed to be the official attacking day, instead they attacked at midnight, when all the people were chanting kirtan all around the country. And then the king was there, at midnight, all of a sudden he heard this just like, you know, huge, you know, cannon fire, one after another. He said, who's fighting? I told nobody's supposed to lift any arms, and nobody knew. And there was this, wow, this immense, like, you know, so many cannons blowing off one after another, and then finally there was like silence. He sent out his spies, and what's going on? What happened? And they went out and they saw these like red hot two cannons lying in the ground. And there was an old guy there, he said, well, what happened? And I said, well, Mr. Radha Mohan came out, the baby came out, took this immense form. He was holding the two cannons, one under each arm. And they're boom, 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 they're going off like anything. And they totally wiped out the entire army of the demon in the Bhaskar Pandit. And then he went back, he went left. You have a drinking or something? I'm drinking, I don't drink. I saw it happening. They told the king said, how is it possible? The Devi went? And they went out and they saw these cannons, and the cannons were so hot, you know. And they don't have, those are all like muzzle loaded cannons, you know. They don't shoot like, you know, this is going off like Gatling guns. Boom, 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 boom. You know. it takes time to load them, you know. So, and they saw the entire army of Bhaskar Pandit was massacred, just completely wiped out. He said they had killed so many brahmanas, and tortured and stolen. So the deity just wanted to, you know, personally get this one. And so they went to the temple where the deity is, and they went in. The deity's, you know, standing there. And but his clothes are all covered with gun smoke powder. Sulfur smoke. And then they still have the cannon that was allegedly the Devi held there on the screen. I thought, I mean, from India perspective, you see what the modern, you know, kind of the best 500 years or empires, and you're actually, then the British, of course, came in after that, and the British Empire was there, the British Raj, and now we have democracy around the world. So, but at this time, King Vijitasva, who was given the name Akardan, because he could see Indra when he was invisible. So then, He got the blessing. He could become visible or invisible like the demigods. He didn't need a spies if he didn't want to. He could just turn invisible, walk around, check out what's happening. He was a pretty amazing personality. Not too many kings to get this ability to become invisible. So, he was such an honest person, he was such a good person, that when Indra was stealing, he could see Indra. He had that mystical power to see the demigods, who are celestial beings. So that obviously he was a very pure person. So that Indra gained more. Not only can you see the invisible, you can become invisible also. So that's part of the history of our world and the whole history of Lord Chaitanya and his associates, followers. So Ganga Safari went to that place one year when we were doing Gormandal Bhumi Parikrama. All of the devotees were hugging the can, seeing the deity. There's a lot of amazing pastimes about the deity, the right way, the pants, and all that stuff. Anybody has any questions? I think what we should do, learn from this though, is that we also descendants, we're disciplic descendants of Srila Prabhupada. And, you know, we have also responsibility. When we cooperate with our older god brothers and god sisters or uncles, everybody has the responsibility to spread Krishna consciousness. It's like these Kshatriyas, they have to rule, you know, in a village. We have to preach, even if it's a Bhakti Bhiksha group, or if it's a Namhat group, or if it's some book distribution, some form of preaching. We're all coming in a dynasty of preachers, Goshtiyanandis. We have to help to spread the Sankirtan movement. So that's our, what shall we say, what's the word, that's our, what's the word I'm looking for? Our heritage. And our obligation to our forefathers in our dynasties. We're coming in a disciplic dynasty, we're disciples. In India, like if I, in the West they don't accept that, in India sometimes you put father's name, so I put Guru Pita, like Guru Father, Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada is my father. And they accept that. That's sannyasi having a father as a guru, they accept that. That's allowed. And all of us, we're disciplined descendants from Prabhupada and our great illustrious previous acharyas. So we have a certain obligation. And we want to create a spiritual empire. How the material empires work out and how they manage this disturbed world. But the spiritual empire, spiritually the whole world can become peaceful through the influence of Lord Chaitanya's mercy. We put our faith in Krishna, and somehow Krishna, he empowers his devotees in different ways, and somehow the will of the Lord fulfills. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So everyone is entitled to think that we should take some responsibility for our guru, for Prabhupada. Maybe a hassle, maybe difficult, maybe something austere. Maybe a thankless task. But if you don't take any responsibility, it's like you're not, what are we here for? What are we existing for? We need to cooperate and help the Krishna Prabhupada's movement, whether it's responsibility for seeing the temple room screen, or whether it's for the book table, or whether it's for Krishna distribution, or foundation development, book distribution, whatever it may be. With some responsibility, some task we should take that we can also contribute for the spreading of Krishna consciousness, whether it's the dancing, Bharatanatyam, the functions. We want to contribute something to furthering the Krishna conscious effort. To please Srila Prabhupada. That's our humble offering. Any question? Comment? Everybody commits, take responsibility. It's not long enough, you have been finished and with the license of the training and all the responsibilities.
The Signor Vrindavan, Italy.
It's good to be right there. So there are some, what is it, a morning?
And you go to the airport, right?
Oh, che è Guru Maharaj di cognome Bolo, da Firenze Francesco, mi sa di Lufthansa, capito? Però non più di 200 dollari. Se poi può più personale,
Thank you. parlato con Gokula. Gokula ha detto che lui ieri sera aveva già trovato un volo da Pisa per 120 euro. Però dice, il problema adesso è che lui non può fare la prenotazione qui a Firenze perché non ha la carta di credito.
E perché non puoi partire da Pisa, bisogna partire per forza a Firenze perché c'è problemi all'altra parte. Non ci possono che venire a prendere lui all'aeroporto all'altra parte. Così devi partire da Firenze e poi bisogna prendere il volo a Lufthansa e lui c'è una biglietto già. Però se lui puoi cambiare, capito? Però c'è bisogno di qualcuno fai cura di questa parte qui, quindi devi partire, bisogna arrivare a Lufthansa e mezzogiorno, perché qui c'è una partenza per America alle 2 e in India alle 2, così lui devi partire. Niente, dire lui, non è che lui bisogna fare il biglietto online, però bisogna vedere se c'è un volo. E poi posso parlare con le servitori, perché anche lui le fa, e poi forse puoi andare nel posto di Pisa per vedere se puoi cambiare questo biglietto, capito?
Lui a mezzogiorno deve essere a Francoforte.
Jaya Vidya Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda He's coming! He's coming! 그리고!
어떻게 하는 거라서 시험 대신 시작을 안 했다. 다른 애인 난다는 거 알아. 알고.
molti lila simultanee stanno correndo in questo battaglia.
Krishna meeting with Radharani at Kurukshetra.
Krishna si incontra con Radharani at Kurukshetra.
Krishna meeting with the Pandavas.
Krishna si incontra con i Pandavas.
Then Krishna what's going on with the Lakshmi, with the Rukmini and Satyabhava.
Krishna arriva con Satyabhava and Rukmini.
And that's the one level, and then there's things like what's happening with the Thakur Rudra Maharaj.
E quello è un livello. Dopo c'è un altro livello per quello che sta succedendo con il Thakur Rudra Maharaj.
And during the Rath Yatra, the Daitas, they had the opportunity to worship Lord Jagannath.
Durante la Yatra, i Daitya Pati, i Daitya, che hanno l'opportunità di adorare su Jagannath.
Puri Jagannath is a really big thing in Jagannath Puri.
In Jagannath Puri è un grande posto, c'è.
Jagannath is a huge, very large stadium. Maybe like 2 meters tall at most. Almost 2 meters wide, a little less.
È enorme, 2 metri di alto e quasi 2 metri di largo.
But he's so he's he weighs very much. So they had to remove him from the altar by a ramp. They had to move him down the stairways by having cushions.
Lo devono spostare dall'altare verso le rampe e lo spostano attraverso le scale con cuscini.
The Daitas, they are the descendants of the Savaras.
The Daitas are the descendants of the Savaras.
Is this explained in text number 8 purport?
Non è spiegato nella spiegazione del verso 8.
The servants of Lord Jagannath take care of the Lord from the day of the Snan Yatra, after the time the Lord is carried from the throne of the Ratna.
I servitori del Signore Jagannath si prendono qui al Signore dal giorno della sua Yatra fino al momento in cui il Signore è conferito dal trono.
These Daitas that come from Savaras, a caste that keeps themselves pigs.
Questi Daita provengono dalla caste Savara che aveva i venti maiali.
Because you know the history is that before Jagannath was the Lila Madhava.
La storia racconta che prima del Signor Jagannath era Lila Madhava.
And that time the king of the Savaras would go and feed Lila Madhava with fruits and rice of jungle delicacies, fruits and fruits.
In quel tempo il re di Savara andava a mangiare Lila Madhava frutta e delicatezze della foresta.
So because the king of the Dunga, he got the Lila Madhava from the Savaras. So all the Savaras were elevated to Daitas.
Il Dunga Maharaj ottenne Lila Madhava dai Savara, allora tutti i Savara furono elevati.
One who has received the mercy of the Lord.
Uno che ha ricevuto la misericordia del Signore.
Daya is mercy.
Daya vuol dire il Signore.
Dayata means to receive the mercy.
Dayata vuol dire chi ha ricevuto la misericordia.
How many of you want the mercy?
Chi di voi vuole la misericordia?
Daya Jagannatha Amiti. We'll get it today by serving the Lord.
E oggi la permette servendo il Signore.
Adorate
a te.
And you give it every day by serving the Lord. Ayatas were Brahmanas, and so they're called Dayatapatis.
Alcune dei Datya erano Brahmanas, allora sono chiamati Dayatapatis.
Daitas are strongly those people, so they were the one moving the Kedir district.
I Daitas sono molto forti, allora sono quelli che spostano la divinità fisicamente.
And the Daitapatis are doing the puja and offerings.
I Daitapatis sono quelli che offrono puja e offrono.
That moving was going on.
Questo spostamento da loro.
So how they moved the Lord, that was also an interesting point.
Come muovevano il Signore, come spostavano, è un punto molto interessante.
Around the Lord's waist, he had a big silken belt.
Intorno al braccio del Signore ci sono queste corde di seta.
So the way they moved the Lord was some they took the shoulders, some climbed from his feet, and they were, as so they took him off of the altar, then they were moving the Lord, they would be like walking.
Alcune persone prendevano le braccia, altre persone prendevano i piedi del Signore e lo bilanciano, lo fanno rivolare che sembra che sta camminando.
the shoulder forward and the feet and the shoulders, so it would be like he's walking.
Avanzano le spalle, dopo avanzano i piedi, dopo le spalle, normalmente così lui va camminando.
And over his head they have a big peacock for the projector.
E sotto la sua testa c'è un enorme piuma d'oro.
It would be like 5 meters high.
Piuma di 5 metri.
So that would move with the Lord.
Perché si muove con il Signore.
In front they have 100, 200 Brahmanas facing each other who are standing with a white chamar.
Di fronte c'è 100 Brahmana che si affacciano con lui e stanno battagliando con il chamar.
They're furious defending.
Una
big long line.
Furiosamente lo.
And in front of them, they have another couple hundred Brahmanas, 100 each side, playing on gongs.
E c'è giustamente un po' più in là, c'è un centinaio, 100 Brahmana che suonano i gongs.
And there's no gongs. So they will hit the gong with their sticks. All at the same time.
Colpiscono questi gong con le stecche e tutti allo stesso tempo.
Boom, 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 boom. All at the same time. 200 people hitting like that. Really hard.
200 persone colpendo questi gong fortemente tutti allo stesso ritmo, allo stesso tempo.
You could hear it for miles, for kilometers.
C'è il sente l'uomo di distanza.
It's like the Lord's on the move.
Il Signore si sta muovendo.
He's moving. He's coming. It's a really intense pageantry, right? I mean,
the most intense.
You know, it's like a king moving. There's a king of the universe, part of the universe, he's moving.
Come un signore che si muove, un re dell'universo.
The first Balaram comes.
Prima arriva Balaram.
I was the president in 1970 for the Iraq captures. After that, Prabhupada told us to make Iraq captures in Calcutta.
Io ero lì nel 1970, per la tagliata del generato, dopo di quello che la mamma ci disse di fare la tagliata.
Since then I've been going to Calcutta with the church, because Prabhupada said to make it the biggest and the best.
Ci la mamma disse di fare questo un anno di tagliata, più grande di tagliata.
But my experience of 30 years ago, I'll never forget.
ma la mia esperienza di 30 anni fa non l'ho mai dimenticata.
I'm sure that it's not changed.
E sono sicuro che non è cambiato.
It's been right like this for thousands of years.
E rimarrà così e rimarrà così per migliaia di anni.
So, this year when they were moving Balaram, they had walked up to his rug.
E questo anno stanno muovendo la rana, devo avanzare indietro.
There's a big ramp going up to it.
Arrivarono la rampa, c'è una grande rampa che usa il carro.
And again, like we have small here, we can kind of lift them up, carry them up the stairway, but here they also have to, they have ropes around his waist behind them. They're also pulling them up this ramp.
Noi abbiamo da più piccoli e possiamo alzare sul carro quando imparano e possiamo alzare le braccia fermanti e lo legano alle braccia con delle corde di seta e lo vanno spingendo su quel terreno di sul carro.
So then, this year, as he was, Balaram was going up,
quando Balaram stava salendo,
he got about halfway up the ramp, huge ramp, maybe 7 meters.
La metà della rampa in saliva, una rampa enorme di 5 metri di larghezza. Molti pugiali arrivarono ancora.
They jump on the back of the other ones and they're pushing Balaram.
Cominciarono a spingere da dietro gli altri.
There was like one pugiali stepping another, pushing Balaram.
Un pugiali camminava su un altro spingendo Balaram.
You can see, I mean, how big Balaram was and how
Visualmente
for Balaram they have white feathers.
Per Balaram c'era
white feathers. So one time Balaram and a peacock
a volte Balaram mette una piuma in loro.
He got attacked by a demon.
Fu attaccato, aggredito da un demone.
So now they're gonna wear peacock anymore.
Allora decisero di non utilizzare piume in pavone.
So someone told me a few days ago.
Questo mi è stato raccontato da un
giorno di mattina. Actually, before they go, I forgot one thing, is that Sudarshan Chakra comes and he goes around the cars in the kirtan, three times.
Prima di questo, Sudarshan Chakra viene e va intorno ai cari tre volte e ogni carro con chi.
Takes away all the auspiciousness.
E purifica tutte le cose auspiciose.
So then, next step is King Pratapurtra comes.
La tappa seguente che aveva fatto la lunga viene.
He, that's like in verse 15. He cleans the robe with a broom that has a golden handle.
El pulisce, pulisce la strada con una scopa con le mani di oro.
He sprinkles sandal with scented water on the road.
E spruzza l'acqua con sandalo della strada.
He is the owner of the royal throne, the Simhasana.
È il proprietario del trono reale, del Simhasana.
Rajasana, he is sitting in the royal throne. He has so many servants. But before the pleasure of Jagannath, he takes the menial position.
Ma per il piacere del signor Jagannath prende la posizione di servitore di lui. Prasad è una installazione di divinità, ho fatto anche in un modo quale.
And that was a really big blessing for Prataguru that he humbled himself before Krishna.
Quella è una benedizione per Prataguru che si messe in una condizione umile.
It's a big thing, you know. I mean, for many people, assuming their role is like beneath their dignity. For many people, assuming their role is beneath their dignity.
Per molta gente, il fatto di pulire la strada è come perdere la dignità.
I am a figure of the street.
Una persona che pulisce la strada, una persona che pulisce la
strada.
Mai.
Some people are like that. So, you want to speak of a king? When we asked once the vice president of India, he came to our function and the president of
Bharatiya.
And then we asked him, and the president asked him, this is the tradition that the king of Puri would always sweep the road in front of Jagannath, so he requests the vice president to sweep the road in front of
Jagannath. L'intendimento dice che la tradizione che il re pulisse la strada davanti a Jagannath, allora gli chiese al vicepresidente della Repubblica che pulisse la strada davanti a Jagannath.
The vice president stood up, we are a republic.
Il vicepresidente dice, molto più, noi siamo una Repubblica.
A democracy.
Siamo una democrazia.
We don't follow
non seguiamo, non seguiamo il presidente.
I will not follow a king.
Io non seguirò un re.
I am a democratic person.
Io sono una persona democratica.
I will not sweep the road.
Io non pulirò la strada. Non spazzerò la strada.
We never faced anybody that refused to speak the Lord. It was a big shock.
Non avevo mai incontrato prima una persona che rifiutasse di passare la strada da sentire un altro grande corpo.
And then I took the microphone.
Allora io ho preso il microfono.
I said, yes, now India is a democracy. Government for the people, by the people, and of the people.
Noi siamo per il popolo, dal popolo e per il popolo.
And therefore we request the people to sweep them, because the people now are the kings. They are the rulers with their votes.
E allora noi chiediamo alla gente di fare questo lavoro di pulire. La gente adesso sono i re, sono con i loro voti, sono i re.
And like the ancient Romans,
who
started the democracy, it's all your fault. And we We've impressed all the people, and we request the vice president as the leader of the people, he should do first.
Allora chiediamo al vicepresidente come leader della gente di farlo prima, di pulire la zona prima di tutti gli altri.
He didn't know how to escape that from this. I don't know what to do. But he swept the road for 1 microsecond.
E passò la strada per 20 secondi.
Everybody else
scratched. Tutti gli altri potevano andare a
vedere. Yesterday came in the newspaper. The next day.
Il giorno dopo parte dei giornali.
Vice President refuses to sweep rock before God.
Il vicepresidente dell'India rifiuta di passare la strada a mezzo di Dio.
So he got his thoughts from the newspaper. So sweeping the road before the Lord, that's a very good thing to do actually, because it humbles one, establishes who's the boss, ultimately God is the boss.
Pulire la strada del Signore è una cosa molto buona perché stabilisce chi è in capo.
And the king of Orissa, their culture, is that Jagannath is the ruler. They are just his servants.
La cultura dei re di Orissa è che il signor Jagannath è il governante, le niente, e loro sono i servitori.
So they never have a bigger palace than Jagannath, for example.
Allora non hanno mai un palazzo più grande che il tempio di Jagannath.
Their palaces are modest in comparison to many other things.
Il palazzo loro è modesto in comparazione con gli altri.
But they function.
Funcionale.
So anyway, what happened? The Lord Chaitanya saw the king sweeping the rock. He got myself.
Allora, quello che successe in quella pagliata che con il signor Chaitanya vide il re che puliva la strada e il nome di Cinque Rosso.
Text 17. Uttama Vinyaratya Kare Kucha Seva Attaiva Jagannath Kipa Bacham.
Verso 17, perché fosse la persona più elevata e rispettabile, il re allora accettato di compiere un servizio tanto umile per il Signore, diventò così un candidato degno che riceve la sua misericordia.
Mahaprabhu Sukhapairo Se Seva Vrikite Mahaprabhu Kipapairo Se Seva Vrikite.
Vedendo il re impegnato in questo servizio così umile, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu si sentì molto felice. Grazie a questo suo servizio, il re riceverà la misericordia del Signore.
You want to get the mercy of the Lord, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Service.
Volete ricevere la misericordia del Signore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, e il re riuscirà.
Lord Chaitanya is universal guru.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu è un universale.
Jagannath is Supreme Lord.
Jagannath è il Signore Supremo.
So, Guru wants to see that the Lord is serving Krishna.
Il Guru vuole vedere i devoti che sono Krishna.
So, in this way, by Jagannath Seva, Prataguru, we got combined mercy on Guru and Krishna.
La Seva di Jagannath, Prataguru, ottenne la misericordia di Guru e Krishna.
Lord Chaitanya taught the Goswami, you need the mercy of Guru and Krishna.
Il Signor Chaitanya disse a Goswami che tu hai bisogno della misericordia di Guru e Krishna.
Robanto Kaliki Guru Bhakti Vati Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lota Bhis. So, this little service started a whole lot of mercy for the Lord, for King Prasanna.
Questo piccolo servizio portò a me da paura una grande misericordia per te.
The car was very tall, very beautiful, looked like it was tallest one male.
Il carro era molto alto, molto bello, più alto di Montenegro.
Jagannath Puri, we are not all buildings. All the buildings are like only two stories.
Jagannath Puri, gli edifici non sono molto alti, gli edifici più grandi c'erano due piani.
At least around the rock.
Meno della strada che non sta.
So there, the rock towers over all the buildings, very beautiful, very impressive.
Il carro della Tayata sorpassa gli edifici, vediamo un po' di.
So, Prabhupada in his purport to text 19, he mentions that in the Guardian, they said, Iskandra Tayata is rival to Nelson Collins and Trafalgar's time.
Nella spiegazione del verso 19 si menziona che la Tayata del disco troneggiava o sorpassava il colonnello denso della Tayata.
So like this, the Lila of Jagannath coming to Italy, it's also expansion of Lord Chaitanya's pastimes.
La vita del Signor Jagannath in Italia è un'espansione dei passatempi del Signor Chaitanya.
It was predicted that Lord Chaitanya would bring the Rathyatra festival all over the world to his tribunal.
Perché fu detto che se ci permando a loro avrebbe portato la battagliata attraverso il mondo e la società del mondo.
This pastime of Jagannath moves to the crowds of people. Here in Italy, that's also divine mercy.
Allora questo passatempo dove il signor Jagannath si muove attraverso il folle gente, qui in Italia è anche una misericordia.
Nitya Lila, eternal pastime.
In Italia è un passatempo eterno.
The extended pastimes of Lord Chaitanya is still going on.
È un passatempo che si estende, un passatempo del Signor Chaitanya che è ancora continuato.
It's very nice that many people as possible can hold it up.
È molto bello, molto buono che tanta gente come sia possibile tirino questo cavolo.
Whether they can chant and dance to and if the people even watch the rap, they also get a blessing. Even just seeing, appreciating all very beautiful.
La gente apprezza questo, osservando quello che dice, anche se apprezza una volta.
I was recently in Woodstock, the festival of Poland, and this year they started a very big rap. It went throughout the crowds of youth.
Sono stato adesso al festival di Woodstock in Bologna e hanno cominciato anche questa volta un altro tagliato che toccava la ragazza andava attraverso il foglio di giovani.
These young people from all the Woodstock are not going, you know, they're going for rock and roll and kind of a tamasic environment that is one of the modes which is there.
Questa gente che va a gusto, che predominantemente va per rock and roll, che è un mood tamasico, che è un predominante.
The little passion and the goodness also. But then you know these young people are not very spiritually oriented, let me say that much. They're very sensual oriented.
Questa gente, questi giovani, non sono molto orientati molto verso la spiritualità, sono sensuali, una orientazione del valore interno sensuale.
But here, Jagannath is going in the midst of 400,000 young people.
And qui vediamo come Jagannath attraverso questa folla di 5.000 persone.
And they're coming forward and looking at the Rajacha.
Some of
them are coming and pulling the chariot.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.